Good day, everyone, and welcome to Adventures with Parker. Today, you're here at the Norfolk County Fair and Horse Show 2022. This is my home county fair. I've been coming here every year since I was maybe 4 or 5. I have so many fond memories associated with this event, and it's one that I look forward to attending every single year. I'm so happy to be back, and in today's vlog, we're going to check out everything that the fair has to offer. The rides, the animals, the agricultural displays, the shows, the food, and everything else in between. I am just so excited, so happy to be here. So without any further ado, let the fair adventures begin. There's really no such thing as a quiet spot in the fair, but the food alley is especially chaotic, so I apologize that we have to go with a voiceover here, but I did want to talk about what I had for lunch. Now, there are always tons of options when it comes to food at the fair, and it's always a struggle choosing exactly what I want to eat, but this year, I decided to get the Great Canadian Taters, otherwise known as the Tater Tot Poutine, or Toutine, from the Get Your Own Taters truck. This spin on a Canadian classic was so yummy, but it was actually too much for me. I could not finish it. It was a lot of food, but I mean, that's really not all that bad of a problem to have. Okay, I am disgustingly full after those tots, so I don't think I'm going to be doing any rides for a bit. But that's okay, because I normally like to start off with all the agriculture stuff, like the poultry barn and the cattle barn. And I hear there's a llama costume contest happening in a few minutes, so I think that's what we're going to check out first.
We have our doctor and nurse coming into the show now. St. Patrick's Day celebration. We have our scary spiders for Halloween. And we have racing stripes. Dorothy and Scarecrow. Damsel and Disher. Our beekeeper and his feet, and all our goodies, Reese's Pieces, and M&M, Forest of Flowers, a little bit of devil, a little bit of angel. Let's welcome two fairies to the Norfolk County Fair, and our unicorns came to visit, Farmer and his cow, or her cow, sorry, Raggedy Ann and Andy. Social media, let's welcome our ballerinas, our turkey and his farmer.
Llama costume contest is just always so adorable, so that's put on by the 4-H club here in Norfolk County, and like I said, they're so cute. And so much hard work goes into those costumes, so much creativity and so much, I mean, knowledge of the kids to just handle the llamas while they're there. So to any of you who are in that show, you guys did an amazing job. So congrats to all of you. So usually they have a poultry barn where they have, you know, chickens, rabbits, ducks, but I guess there's some kind of provincial order preventing that from happening this year, so that's disappointing. Ah, okay, so I was reading this notice here. Apparently there's an outbreak of avian influenza, and that kind of makes having poultry shows unsafe right now, so that's why the barn's closed this year. That sheep has the sneezes. The sheep sneezes. These are my favorite kind of cows. They're called Galway cows, but they kind of look like Oreos. Then this guy is what you'd call an Angus cow. It's a type you'd use mostly for beef and things like that. And then this fella is a Jersey cow. Well, hello there. So our noisy friend over there was a milking shorthorn, and this one is a Guernsey. Right next to her, we have a Holstein sitting there on the hay. At the back there, you can see all the piglets. There's one sticking his head up. Hello. Oh, that one's on the move. Where are you going? I love seeing the livestock every year, but I really can't stay in there long before my asthma starts acting up. But we are going to be heading over to the other non-livestock agricultural displays, and those are underneath the grandstands. Hey! Oh my gosh, guys. It's corn. I can't imagine a more beautiful thing. Goodness, guys, I cannot believe my eyes. It was so bad. So one of the coolest parts of the beekeeping display is not only can you see the bees, you can actually buy some of the honey that the bees have made. These are the entries in the decorated child's toy category, and oh my goodness, they're all so cute. This is this year's champion pumpkin, 1,884 pounds. Now that's one big pumpkin. And I believe it broke the Norfolk County Fair record this year. So this is the biggest pumpkin that has ever been at the fair and all of its many, many years of it running. And here are our tallest sunflowers of the year. Look at that one, it goes right up to the ceiling. So that sunflower is coming in at 22 feet and 3 inches tall. Oh my goodness.
Hey, back in the livestock show ring, we're just catching the end of the llama obstacle course. Thank you.
are a total of 7 breweries that produce white milk for us for human consumption in Ontario. Who knows what kind of cow this might be? What breed of cow? You're very close. It is a milky shorthorn. And there's the Holstein, the most popular cow in North America, as well as the Jersey, the Guernsey, Ayrshire, Milky Shorthorn, Brown Swiss, and the Canadiana cow. There are 3 things that a cow has to have or do before it makes milk. What are the 3 things that a cow has to have or do before it makes milk? Yes, eat, that's right. So a farmer has a dairy nutritionist who comes to the farm, takes samples of the feed, and sends it to a lab, and then he comes back with a recipe for the farmer to make a TMR. That's a total mixed ration. And he puts all the ingredients in a great big cup that has actually 2 beaters in there that grind it all up and mix it up evenly like a casserole. So what else does a cow have to have or do before it makes milk? Yes, that's right. It has to have a calf. At the age of 2, it has its first baby calf. Milk for 10 months, and dry for 2 months. Have another calf. Milk for 10 months, dry for 2 months. And so it continues on. It has to eat, has to have a calf, and water, that's right. In fact, cows drink over a bathtub full of water. That's an average of 120 liters of water per day. And that's because the average cow makes 30 liters of milk per day. He's going to take a paper towel, and he is going to scrub those teeth, and that's going to stimulate the cow to drop her milk. It signals to the cow, it is time to be milked. And she can massage it at the same time, and they like that. You can put it on your farmer Charlie. All right, we're going to see that milk going down the tube, up the hose, and then into the pipeline. Then the milk goes through a filter. And this filter catches any dirt or straw or sawdust that was accidentally vacuumed up when the milk machine was being put on.
Okay, I think it's time that we check out the Midway. Now, the rides here at the Norfolk County Fair are provided by World's Finest Shows Midway, and they've been doing that for as long as I can remember. There's lots of classics returning this year, as well as a couple of rides I don't recognize from previous years. So there's lots to check out. I'm really excited to hop on some rides and get some thrills. Now, you can purchase individual ride coupons at these ticket booths. There's also ride all day wristbands available, but you have to purchase those ahead of time. You can get those from any Wilson's location, and that's just a chain of local pharmacies that we have here in Norfolk. If you don't buy it ahead of time, they are available on Monday, but that's the only day that you can buy them. Other than that, you're stuck using tickets. Okay, so our first ride of the day is Orbiter, aka Troika's crazy deranged sister. Boy, those kind of drop towers where you can't see the top when you're on it will never not freak me out. I love them, but they scare me every single time. Okay, so Fireball has always been one of my favorite rides here at the fair. It's just so much fun, and it kind of is the closest thing to an adult thrill coaster. I mean, it's not a coaster, but it's close, you know what I mean? Like, it has the track, it has the looping aspect to it, so it's one that I always look forward to riding every year. All right, taking a quick peek at the Kids Midway here, we have the Carousel, which is always a classic, and it's looking really good this year. I don't know if it's a new one, but it looks nice, it looks really nice. We have Jumbo, if you've ordered Jumbo from Wish. Here it's actually called Jumping Jumbos, but same concept. We even have a little circus mouse in the middle. Oh my goodness, this is such a ripoff. That's so cute. We've got Monkey Mayhem, which is a small teacup style attraction, but instead of teacups, you're riding in giant multicolored mustached monkeys. I don't remember the mustaches when I was younger, but I love it. Oh man, when I was a kid, I spun these so hard and so fast. I was so scared I was gonna come right off the little arm there. My friends hated riding with me, but I had so much fun. And I haven't seen this ride here for a while, but it looks like in 2022, the Cobra Coaster has made a return. This ride has a lot of meaning to me personally because I believe it's the first coaster that I've ever been on as a kid. So yeah, it's kind of cool to see it back here again after all these years. Of course, the Cobra Coaster isn't the only credit you can get here. We also have the return of the world famous Wacky Worm. So I always like to try at least one interesting fair food a year, and this year's pick are the Yeti Puffs. They actually gave me a coupon earlier when I was walking by, so I knew I had to come back. So I got to upgrade to get that Oreo, but these are like nitrogen puffs, I guess? Very interesting. Okay, the Yeti Puffs were very interesting. I mean, once the nitrogen ran out, they were really just like fruity puffs. They were still good, but the novelty was definitely in the nitrogen. I'm glad I tried them. It was something different. I've never seen anything like that before. So yeah, very cool. And then of course we ran into Bandoloni, which is the one man band. He's been performing at the fair ever since I was young. So he's been doing this for so many years and it's always great to see him again. I'm always so worried that one year I'm gonna come to the fair and he's gonna be retired, but nope, he's still going strong and he's always a fun show to see. So if you can, definitely make time to see Bandoloni.
Come on out everybody, it's showtime. Perform a reverse somersault or a gainer flip, same thing, but he's gonna land back on top of the board before doing a dive of his choice into the pool. Now, as you can imagine, this is a pretty dangerous idea. That board is not a very big target, and in reality, neither is that pool. So, before he goes, let's give him a little encouragement, everyone, for Saxon, the spotter.
Once Flavor Fest is now the Norfolk Fair Market and has been relocated here inside the Annalise Carr Aquatic Center. So let's head in and check it out. We've got the photo displays here from the photography and art competitions. It's not happening right this second. It looks like they're on a break, but they have axe throwing this year. That's new. I don't think they've had that in previous years. And here is the Norfolk Fair Market. Brand new for this year, or like I said, rebranded and relocated. Looks like they have lots of good options this year. Cheese curds. Oh man, I love cheese curds. Guys, there are plants. I'm so tempted, but I know I can't lug a plant around for the rest of my evening, but I might come back before I go. We'll see. The temptation is real. I'm also really digging these candles from Country Home Candle. This is the Nightmare in Norfolk one. It kind of smells like a cheesecake, I guess. I don't know. It's kind of weird. Then there's this butter and maple one that smells exactly how it sounds. It is so delightful. Yeah, I've been needing a fall candle for this season, and if I'm gonna get one, I might as well support local, right? So I think I'm going to get the butter and maple candle. It's a little bit smaller and a little more expensive than the other ones, but it does have a wooden wick, which is always a plus in my opinion. I'm also getting this t-shirt from The Folk, which is a local clothing company here in Norfolk County. I've been wanting to buy something from them for a while, and I think this is perfect. It kind of doubles as fair merch. Yeah, this is a good find. Okay, another new big addition for this year. Lounge 5. We've got live music. We've got local craft breweries. What more could you want? We'll be right back. Tim Hortons is here with their promotional trailer, and they are pretty much giving away free coffee. So instead of buying coffee as you normally would, you just simply make a donation to the fair board. So cheers, here's a double on Tim's. Fairground dark rides are so janky, half the effects don't work, and yet I still love them, flaws and all. One of the big draws to the fair every year is the Party on the Track, which is a big headlining concert. In other years, they've had like Carly Rae Jepsen, they've had Mumford & Sons, and this year, it's Walk Off the Earth. I love Walk Off the Earth. They're such a cool band, and they always do such interesting things with their music. Unfortunately, my phone died before the end of the concert, but I think I pretty much captured the overall vibe. One highlight that I do want to mention that I wasn't able to film though, is that they did a live rendition of their cover of Somebody That I Used to Know. So if you haven't seen the original YouTube video, back in 2012, they did a cover with a 5-person guitar. So yes, they brought that guitar out, they did the song, as well as a few others. And overall, the concert was just so much fun. Anyways, that's going to do it for my day at the Norfolk County Fair and Horse Show 2022. As I said at the beginning of the video, this fair just means so much to me, and I'm just so glad that I'm able to return to it year after year, and that I'm able to capture it and, you know, share my memories and experiences of it on the channel here. It makes me so happy that I'm able to do that. Anyways, if you would like to see more theme park, travel, local, and outdoor adventures, be sure to subscribe. You can also find me on social media at @ADVParker. Big thank you to my patrons for all of your continued support. If you would like to support the channel for as little as a toonie a month in exchange for some sweet perks and behind the scenes content and bonus content and a whole bunch of good stuff, head over to patreon.com/adventureswithparker. Once again, thank you so much for joining me, and until next time, the adventures are calling.